Grapes, berries, and vegetables. Early memories of fields resplendent with poppies inspired her to give them a place. Admiring the philosophy of landscaped architect James Keeter, Ada asked him to gently sculpt the garden. In his design, James drew attention to the impressive array of indigenous species. Additions did not impose, but rather complemented the land-made structure. His framework allowed Ada to pursue the talents begun in childhood, personifying her imagination through her garden and her paintings.
My paintings come from the garden. The colors in my paintings are directly from the garden. Sometimes to people, I think my paintings, the color seems too bright, but it is the exact color of the flowers that I'm seeing in the garden, because sometimes I have even taken the flower, brought the flower out of the garden up to the studio, set it in front of the painting and think, this is the perfect color, and then I'll put that color into the painting. So that the garden, and the painting has taught me about the garden, because I will design the colors of the foliage and the flowers to make a composition in the garden. And I take photographs of the different places in the garden so that I can criticize them at different seasons and see if I need some more silver gray or some more bright green. I use the foliage mainly, the colors of the foliage to design with, because I learned that when I was in England, that which was very interesting to me. I had never thought about it before, but that the color, the textures of the foliage is the thing that is best to use in your design, because that is always there, whereas the flowers come and go.
An activist in the preservation of the Texas landscape, Ada treasures nature's self-appointed compositions.
One of the secrets is that in nature, if you see a field of bluebonnets, a field of bluebonnets will start with a few bluebonnets. And then they throw their seeds and it gets larger and larger, like ink spreading or paint loosely spreading in a painting, watercolor. So I've learned that to plant seeds of a flower, I put them all right together so that they'll be there in a colony when they come up. Or when I'm planting a plant, I will plant, say, 3 or 4 or 5 close together, and then wait and let them reproduce and make a colony. So that it's, and then you'll have one every once in a while. Of course, there'll be one single little plant that's thrown its seed out far. So, but I try to think the way that the plants spread themselves.
A rapport with her surroundings is echoed in home and lifestyle.
My garden is my partner. I've thought about this for a long time. It's like the completion of my being. It's like if you have a best friend, that you complete each other somehow. Well, the garden is my best friend. And I know where every single flower is, where every tiny bug that comes, the first leaf, I'll see it, because I'm walking in the garden, and these are like, I told someone the other day, they're like my children. But it's really like my very best friend, because it has restored me many times when my heart was very heavy. It is it keeps my stability when things are chaotic. I can go into the garden and start digging, and immediately everything falls away, and it's like a wonderful calming influence, or it makes me feel very close to nature, close to the earth, like I'm part of it, you know, and it continues. It's something that keeps continuing, and it keeps teaching you about death and life, and it's very optimistic. Gardeners are optimistic people, because you're always planning for what's going to happen. So you're planning for the future, and then you're waiting. You know, you're waiting to see, and that's it's a really important part of my life. I have never had a time in my life when I didn't garden.
I hope that you enjoyed that beautiful feature on Ada McElhenney's garden. She is truly an artist both on canvas and around her home.